Barkeeper, one of your finest, frothiest beers, s'il vous plaît. I want it so frothy that I'll get a big, frothy milk-style moustache, something I can really quaff and enjoy. I want maximum frothiness. What the f***? The beer foam is missing. The head is missing. The fluffy little hat. And you can't have a beer without a little fluffy hat. It's what makes a beer worth drinking. At least I say so, and this is my show, which is why today I want to find out what makes a beer head form. Yes, there is physics involved, and fortunately there was a scientist at the bar. I'm sure they'll be willing to help out. But to begin with, let's do a little experiment. Now, I have been told I have to make the show more family-friendly by the d**ks upstairs. So, let's start by making a little story time out of it. So here we have two kingdoms. Over here on the left, we have, let's say, Beerland. And on the right, Tonic Town. Two very different kingdoms, following very different castle doctrine. Now, as we can already see, the bubbles, or citizens of Beerland, are sticking around much longer than they are in Tonic Town. So clearly some interesting physics are happening in here, but science boy, would I be right in thinking this has something to do with proteins?
Alex, you don't even need a science boy.
I don't have a lab coat.
You're quite right though, it's the proteins.
Ah.
Your beer is made from wheat and barley, and that's where the proteins come from. But let's start from the beginning. Look at the bubbles in Tonic Town.
Mm-hmm.
Where are they going?
They're going up.
Sure. So the gas is less dense than the liquid, so it likes to go up to the surface. When those bubbles reach the surface, there's then only a very thin layer of liquid around the bubble. So in the tonic here, that liquid is free to run around the bubble and it can escape and the bubble bursts. Now remember about proteins, Alex?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So the chemical structure means one side loves to be in water, and the other side hates it. So the protein as a whole is happiest at the edge of the bubble, where one side can be in the water, one side can be in the air, and everyone's happy. And so those proteins line up around the bubble and form a protective barrier. That barrier is what stops the bubble from bursting.
Oh, that's a very long way of saying I'm right. Thank you very much. Excellent. So I'm sure, like me, you will want to know one important thing. How come different beers have different heads?
Well, some beers just don't have any gas. Think of an ale.
Ooh.
Without the gas, you can't have the foam, right? But here's the thing. Even for the same beer, you can get different heads depending on the shape of the glass, how it was poured, the temperature, and even if you were having greasy food that night. And of course, the beer isn't the only place that you might find a foam in the kitchen. Think about the frothy milk on your cappuccino.
Mm.
Think about meringues. Think about souffles. All of these foods rely on the proteins to make that protective barrier around the bubbles and to create a foam.
Once again, it's all about those amazing proteins. Science, science everywhere, and oh so much to drink. Here, you have that one. I'll have this. You're only small. Cheers.
Cheers.
Ah, oh, that's lovely. Oh. What? Don't let you drink at your lab. Child.